Hello, beautiful Virgo. I hope you're doing well. Welcome into the Gifted Hermit. My name's Leela. I reside in London, UK. And if you'd like to, in the comment section below, let me know where you reside. Always intrigued to know my viewers are from. You can even tell me a little bit about yourself. Mercury's in retrograde currently. We also have this lunar eclipse in Scorpio that is coming on Sunday, Monday, depending on where you are in the world. So we've got a lot of changes and maybe a lot of miscommunications. Okay, people may come back from the past or get in touch with you. Only you would know, Virgo, if that person serves you well or not. So I like the bottom of the deck already. We have the Fool card here. Something about taking a leap of faith, going for it, Virgo, you know. Living life and a carefree attitude. So hope, oh, look, confirmation. Maybe this is what you're going into, this energy, c'est la vie energy, which I love. But it's almost like living your life to its fullest and to the purpose of who you want to be. Okay, so you now, the heart of the matter. I'm going to do a Celtic cross for Virgos. Where is Virgo at today with the Celtic cross? You now, the heart of the matter, Virgos. You could just have Virgo in your chart, right? Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, Virgo, Celtic cross. You could be a cross watcher. Remember that you can book me for a personal reading, my lovelies. Don't forget to smash the like button if you find that it resonates with you in any way. So, Virgo, you now the heart of the matter. Too many cards. Celtic cross for Virgo. See, I like that energy. I just want one card though. I'm going to be very particular. You now the heart of the matter. I mean, it could be a case of you guys are really trying to love yourself, all right? But with it coming out reversed, I feel like maybe for some of you, you feel like a bit of a misfit. There needs to be more self-care here, more self-love, more self-understanding, more empathy for yourself and your emotions. You know, my loves, don't be hard on yourself. That's what we get with the Queen of Cups in reverse. That definitely states it's a time of self-love. It's a time of maybe you're feeling a bit insecure. You know, you may be a bit dramatic about stuff. You know, trying to control your emotions or suppress them, bring them to the surface. Now's the ultimate time to do it. Okay. This is a time for you to be responsible for your own emotions, all right? It's good. Everything's a learning curve. What's the challenge? What's the blockage for Virgo? What is the challenge? What is the blockage? So, yeah, we've got two fives here. I mean, the challenge is, I feel like there is a lot of sadness here that you hold within you, Virgo. And of course, this is not going to resonate with everybody. But I feel like the challenge is maybe sometimes not hearing what you like to hear. Sometimes just stuck in your mind, stuck in your emotions. Okay. The number five definitely indicates change. So maybe you know something's got to change, something's got to give. Because I feel like you hold on to a lot of sadness. Because we have two cups here that they're not even concentrating on the love that's here. Like two people on their knees. So that's kind of like what I'm getting for the. I'm going to leave that there. Let's do the conscious goal for Virgo. There we go. Ace of Cups. Conscious goal. Falling in love. New connections, new people in your life. Falling in love with yourself. Maybe doing some crying. Crying is cleansing to the heart, you know, to the soul. But the Ace of Cups is a beautiful energy. Consciously, you want to fall in love. You want to open your heart. You want to be happy. You got to let go of this challenge. And sometimes it is a challenge doing the shadow work, trying to keep in a positive mindset. But there's consciously, you know that there's something hopeful here. whether it's new connections, new romantic relationships, friendships, there's seeds of love, there's seeds of hope here in your conscious mind. You want to be happy. You want to open your heart. You want to do better. Subconscious unknown influence for Virgo. What's going on deep down in the core? What's going on deep down in the core? Subconscious unknown influence for Virgo. What's the subconscious influence for Virgo? So, give me one card, please, because I feel like there was two people there, two people on your mind subconsciously, you know, whether you know it or not. Give me one card for the subconscious unknown influence for Virgo on this Celtic cross. I'm going to put out some oracles afterwards as well, Virgo. So there'll be a timestamp as well in the description for the oracle message. Oh, too many cards. So what I do, I look at this. Subconsciously, you're trying to move forward, but you find it very hard. Maybe you're trying too hard. And not every Virgo is going to want to hear that, okay? Subconsciously, you're going through some changes, okay? And these changes talk about your determination. How far you want, are you willing to go? How far are you willing to press on, okay? Because there's a coldness here, deep down in the core of you, okay? Deep down in the core of you, you feel stuck at times. You know, you want to change. You actively want to change. You're doing your best to transition, to get past something here, okay? And you work your butt off. And your quality of life is very important to you. But you feel a bit stuck. And I feel like, majorly, what the factor is here is how you view yourself. How far you're willing to push yourself. Past influence for Virgo. Past influence for Virgo. So we have the Eight of Swords and the Three of Pentacles. So in the past, you've held on to stuff, or maybe you felt responsible in some area of your life, whether it's to a person, a job, a responsibility. But something doesn't serve you here. It didn't serve you here. I think like in the past, you was like, I need to see shit for what it is here. You know, because the Eight of Swords talks about, again, being stuck. Stuck to shit that doesn't serve you. It talks about a time to open your eyes and see the truth. Because you know that you got to work your butt off to get results. You know that you need to cooperate with yourself, with others. This is like, in the past, you're like, you know, this is an opportunity for me to now work on myself and get away from this certain life or this certain person. Okay, this is you wanting to manifest something here, beautiful. This is about you wanting to learn from past shit. Because I know deep down, a lot of you Virgos know that there's no limit to what you can achieve. When you guys are kind to yourself, you're really kind to yourself. Like, you know, you wanted to step your vibration up, your conscious mind. A lot of you wanted to do shit differently in your lives, really change the paradigm, the way you're living, whatever it was. So approaching influence for Virgos. Hopefully we can zhuzh this up a bit. Now, this is what I'm talking about, approaching influence. We have the Judgment card here and the Empress card. So I feel like you guys are coming into this nurturing energy where you're going to be nurturing yourselves. The Empress card does signify pregnancy, just to let you guys know. But I feel like it's coming to a realization that you're not going to be judging yourself as much. the approach and energy seems to be very beautiful, enjoying life, coming to a realization, like this aha moment, like, yes, this is it. This is what I was meant to do. This is how things are supposed to fall into place. Like, it's all falling into place, that type of energy. Like, realizing something here, like a spiritual awakening, redemption. Like, you know, this is total transparency, like your spirit being unveiled, what you're truly meant to always be. The goddess that you are, or the god that you are. This is abundance. This is unconditional love, mind, body, and spirit. So whether that's how you're going to be feeling about yourself, how the world's going to view you, but or someone else feels about you. Wow. Judgment card signifies Scorpio energy. The Empress card signifies Taurus and Libra energy. Okay. What is your talent? What is your inner resources? What is Virgo's talent or inner resource at this time? Virgo's talent or inner resources. Virgo's talent or inner resources. Too many cards. Virgo's talent or inner resources. Well... Ah, it's funny. Thank you. Thank you so much, Spirit. That's what I feel this. Your talent, your inner resources is learning the lessons, is going within, being real with yourself, taking a step back, taking time for yourself, really knowing what it is you want in life. Always falling back to that, falling back to your dreams, your aspirations, you know, life lessons, going within for the answers instead of outside noise, you know? I love it. I freaking love it. How others see you. How are others viewing Virgo at this time? Wow. So this is beautiful energy. How you're being viewed by others is somebody that is quite confident. A woman that knows, or a man that knows what they want. We've got Pisces energy again. The full card talks about Aquarius energy. Okay, so the month of January, February may have some sort of significance here. But yeah, I definitely pick up on others seeing you as kind of like a badass, you know, a successful person in your own right. Seductive, maybe, quite sultry. Someone that wants to live life, someone that is prepared to take risks, take that leap of faith. Maybe quite childish. And I mean that in a good way. I don't know if you've ever been called childish, because we are big kids at heart. So it's like there's two sides of you. There's like a childlike side to you, and everyone should have a childlike side. And then there's this really grown up side to you, and you know what you want. Maybe you stated it, and that's how you're coming across. So I think that's amazing. Hopes and fears for Virgo. Hopes and fears for Virgo at this time. Not winning, big energy. Like, you want to be in that. You want to be, whether it's recognized or you want that sort of, you want results for your efforts, right? You want that TLC, you want victory, you want success. And you fear of not winning, you fear of not being the best that you could be. You fear of not getting what it is that you know you deserve. Whether that's TLC, recognition, rewards for all your efforts. Six of Wands is being appreciated, inspiring others, people looking up to you. You don't want people to look down on you. You hate that shit. So, what is the outcome for Virgo? What is the outcome on this spread? What is the outcome for Virgo? Wow. The Lover's card. So, whether it's a love for life, a love for yourself, January, February, March, April, May, June, the month of June, could be love coming in for you, Virgo singles, okay? But it's a choice. What choice are you going to make? It talks about romantic relationships. It talks about unity. It chooses Virgo, it's about choosing yourself to fall in love, like really fall in love, be vulnerable. This is about healthy boundaries. This is about soulmates. This is about opening your heart, like, to deeply meaningful relationships. This is about expanding in a union. Loving yourself, trust. Let's get to the oracle messages. So I want to get a couple Amanda Lovelace cards. The oracle message for Virgos. The oracle message for Virgo. You can manifest your every wish. Okay, you can manifest your every wish, Virgo. And the number 5 there. And we are in the 5th month right now. Morning. The world awaits you. And then if you're a morning bird, starting off fresh, a new fresh day. That's one good thing about the morning, isn't it? It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good. Look, mirror, treat your body like the palace it is. She's dancing. She's maybe getting out a little bit. I like it. Treat your body like the palace it is. Being kind to yourself. Library, take control of your own narrative. You write the script. Free will is always at play. Don't be puppeted around by anybody else. You know, if that happens, then it can lead us into roads we don't want to take. So stay on your present path. That's what I say. Now, angels, what do we have for Virgo? I mean, we've got 3 cards that came out there. Okay, calm down, angels. The opportunity to forgive. This situation brings you the opportunity to heal, grow, and release negative patterns. Hold the intention of seeing the other person's inner divine light and goodness. We will help you release unforgiven thoughts, feelings, and energies and lift you to a higher place of peace and compassion. An opportunity to forgive, to heal, to forgive yourself, to forgive others, to grow, to release. What is it that you desire? You now have the opportunity to write the script according to your heart's true desires, Virgo. Once you clearly decide upon your true desires and know that you're ready and deserving of them, they'll rush into your life as if by magic. You got to know that you deserve it. You got to know that you're manifesting what it is that you truly desire. When you're real with what it is that you truly want, you truly expect, it leaves no space for others to abuse that. So yeah, I have that belief, like, to my kings and queens. I hope you have a fantastic weekend, wherever you are in the world. I hope this brought you some sort of joy, clarity, insight, you know. I want you to know that you are loved, you are appreciated. Virgos, 3 of Wands, abundance, things look very good. Have patience at this time, Virgo, and make long-term plans. Look into the future now. The future's bright. The future's orange. You know, look at that volcano. You're ready now. You're ready to explode, to live life to the fullest. Don't give up. Protect that which you've created. Have courage and believe in yourself. Focus. Communicate with vision. And be a leader. Advice from someone creative. A complex decision. The need to do research. Stop procrastinating. A celebration. A wedding. Graduation. Or birth announcement. The need to have more fun. Do you get it, Virgo? Do you get it now? Hopefully you do. Be kind to others, Virgo, but most importantly, be kind to you, all right? And I'll catch you on the rebound, my lovelies.